here is the lovely thing. Today, the round of applause applies honestly more than ever. We're very lucky in the guests we have today because they're here to talk about a film that, and I rarely say this, I don't know, anyone who's watched the show knows that I rarely say this, but this is a film that really we should watch. It is emotional, it is funny, it is clever, and it is transportive, should such a word exist. Mm-hmm. But, and if it doesn't, it should. But I was completely transported by Death in the Gunj, and we're going to be talking about why, which is why I'm thrilled to say we have the Gunj gang with us. So Vikrant, Konkona, Kalki, Ranveer.
Thank you, Anisha. We've been watching the show forever. And
oh, thanks. Gosh. So to you, my first question, and we're going to spread out to everyone else, is what's going on? Like, do you do everything well?
No.
Yes, is the correct answer to that. I mean, again, and if you're looking at the reviews, everyone's saying it's just such an assured directorial debut. Like,
No, so I'm very pleased that people are saying that. We are all very happy and excited. We've all done this together. It's I had so many amazing people on this team and really wish that everyone could be here, but there's so many of us, we wouldn't fit.
But it really felt like a family. Like, it felt like a gang of people that have hung out with each other their whole lives. And I'm going to go out on a limb and say that couldn't be just on screen, right? There had to be some of it that spilt off screen as well.
We've hung out in real life.
We've known each other for a while. Vikrant, I just met.
Barring Vikrant,
Which actually but that works nicely in the context of the film.
But the rest of us, Gulu, Tilly,
Jim, we've all hung out.
Anyway. So a friend of mine said that you should just call it Yari Road Productions. Because everyone is from Versova Yari Road, which is great. And they've all worked together. Like, some of them have worked in, you know, a play together, Rajat's fantastic play, Macbeth and others. Yeah. You know, they've worked in films together. Yeah. They all kind of knew each other. Plus, we did a workshop beforehand with Atul Mongia, who did a fantastic job. And because we were going to go to a cold place, that rehearsal space where we used to rehearse, he used to put on the AC really and make it really cold. And we were encouraged to wear our warm clothes and come there and do our rehearsals so that we'd get into that zone, remember?
And encouraged to drink whiskey also quietly.
We did that.
I see. So it's all starting, and again, it's all starting to make it abundant sense.
Yeah. In fact, Coco would get a bit annoyed because she'd be like, you guys are not on a holiday now. Okay, we're doing a film.
They were having so much fun. I was just envious, I think.
All right. So why don't we just introduce yourselves, your characters, to this audience. So we'll start here with Shutu.
I play this character called Shamal Chatterjee, very fondly called Shutu by his loved ones around. And he's Gulshan's cousin. I play Gulshan's cousin, Nandu's cousin actually in the film. And what happens on that vacation within that 1 week is, you know, what transpires is what the film is about.
So
please watch it.
He's the shy boy. Carrying a little bit of baggage which is not just fitted to the suitcase, right?
So nicely put. Wow. Yeah.
Or in the car trunk.
He's the 23-year-old cousin. He's a bit of a hanger-on.
Social awkward.
I think he's a bit of a pylon actually.
Yeah. Yeah, for some, yes. For some, definitely. Yeah.
Oh, yes. Which brings us
to
you.
I play Mimi, short for Mithali. She is an unmarried woman in her 30s. She enjoys a cigarette and a stiff drink, and she enjoys a lot of attention from men. Right. She knows that she's sexy, and she's not apologetic about it. But I think that she also kind of struggles with whose attention she seeks.
Right. And who she gets and who she doesn't get. Yes.
So this is 79. So I think at that time for a woman to not be married, invites a certain judgment and scrutiny as well, which she doesn't really care about at the same
she
time.
She doesn't care about, but then it affects her, obviously. I mean, she has a lot of insecurities.
I am Vikram Singh Chaudhary.
Right.
I am
Vikramjeet Chaudhary.
Vikramjeet.
Yeah, Vikram.
But Kalki Gunj has royalty. I'm intrigued by this.
One of the provinces, I guess, around.
Yeah, I think Gunj royalty in the sense that, you know, he's like one of the big guys and one of the big shots of McCluskey Gunj. But royalty, in this film, we've said only because he's kind of vaguely related to, you know, the Tripura royal family, you know, some distant cousin or something. So some property and some royal heirs.
Rashness, I suppose.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And a feeling of untouchability.
I have my way, kind of.
You do?
Yeah.
He had a question, I think, about the trailer, right?
Actually, I just saw the trailer and it was not very much clear. It was a bit of horror in it and it was a mystery as well. So I just want to ask you what genre you would put in it, the movie.
I think it has an element of suspense and mystery. It's not typically a thriller, But so it's like a family drama which is packaged in some kind of thriller, but in a suspenseful way. Because it's a family that goes on a vacation. From the title, it's clear that someone is going to die. But we, and through this 1 week that we show of the holiday, we kind of discover what the circumstances are which lead up to one person dying and how or why.
But it's definitely not horror.
It's definitely not horror.
It's not like boom.
Yeah. Although there's a scene in there which has that.
Yeah.
I just saw which that. Was in the trailer, I think. No?
Yeah, it was in the trailer that he pushed a glass and he freaked out.
Yeah, I give him a pretty tough time.
You do.
I mean, off camera.
Which helped in front of the camera, actually.
So, yeah, so again, I mean, your first film, this, I mean, the staggering cast, what was your first biggest challenge with all of them? Did anyone in particular you were...
Trouble me?
Yeah.
Now's the time to trouble me.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, if my gaze happens to drift to the side a little bit, it's purely unintentional.
No. So helpful and supportive all of them were. And I was also very smart because I pretty much left them on their own and stayed away.
Right.
Because I felt like because they looked like they were having a lot of fun.
Yeah.
You know? Even post-shoot or during shoot when they were hanging on and stuff, they looked like they were having a lot of fun. And I thought, like, if I get sucked into it, then I'll forget all my work. You know, then I just want to hang with them. Because all of them together, especially, they're quite a force of nature. I feel like they have this tremendous energy and, you know, they just bounce off each other.
Was it fun? Like, just the adventure, the shooting?
I think this fun illusion is a little illusion. Because, you know, we were firstly living in Ranchi and traveling. I don't want to comment on that. But I'm just saying we were traveling from Ranchi 2 hours every day to McCluskey Gunj. And on a really bumpy one way. So 4 hours drive every day. Plus, God knows, 8 hours of shoot at least.
And I have to add here that Haruna-san was a trooper for having done that for a month with us.
Yeah, that's true. Haruna was a tough shoot.
It was a tough shoot. It wasn't like we were like having a great time partying the whole time. But yeah, we did have the camaraderie of hanging out and complaining about everything together.
And one imagines that like that there's a lot of scenes which involve just a lot of players all at the same time, right? And so... Again, I don't know, but they're just these wonderful scenes, right? And there's lots of people and it's like this big, unruly, unwieldy family that's gathering. And it's exactly like a family gathering, I imagine, for one of us would be. So for you directing, for you as participants in it, like stepping on each other's lines, was that something that added to it? So spontaneous. It's so natural.
But it's not. It's not really spontaneous. It's scripted and then workshopped.
Right.
And then, of course, we had... little bit of freedom, whatever that we got to.
And actually, where we did improvise was a nightmare for you, remember? When we had to dub, because there were bits where we didn't have lines and there was a little like pre-rolling moments. Yeah. And we're just talking, faffing, any rubbish, nothing like to do with the plot or anything. Yeah. And that's, she had a lot of trouble with dubbing us because, you know, we're overlapping each other. It's a big group of people talking over each other.
It translates, you know, when you see the scenes with everybody there. I mean, you can feel it. I think it comes across through.
It is, as one is very often.